Laura Jackson here with Discovering Dyscalculia. I was sorting through some papers this last week and I found something from a few years back when we started teaching my daughter math at home using some curriculum out of the UK specifically for dyscalculia. And we had started using Rana Bird's ebooks. First was Understanding Numbers Through Dot Patterns, and then the second one was Understanding Numbers Through Cuisenaire Rods. These were huge for my daughter. At this point, she was 12 years old, but really lacked a foundational sense of number. And so after we had worked through these two ebooks, there was one day where we decided to just kind of do a fun activity. She was really into like secret messages at that point. So I made a chart 1 through 10. And I said, let's draw a couple different ways that you understand numbers now, two different visuals for how you see numbers. And so this one is the first one I found this week, and it's numbers 1 through 10. And what she did is she drew first the dot pattern over here of 1 through 10. And these are the dot patterns by their doubles and near double dot patterns from Dorian Yeo. And they are the ones that Ronit Bird uses in her ebooks, as well as Jane Emerson and Patricia Babti in their books. Anyway, so she drew the dot patterns that goes with the numbers. And then she also drew the Cuisenaire rod length and color. So that went pretty easy. She was having no problem. And then I gave her the next page, which was numbers 11 through 20. And I remember she looked at me and she was like, how are we going to do those? And like, I could just see, you know, her mind was thinking, and I didn't answer the question for her. And then it was like a light bulb went on. She's like, oh, she's like, there is a 10 in each of these numbers, a 10 plus another number. And here she was, 12 years old. And talk about the assumptions we make about what dyscalculics understand. And even though she was in sixth grade at this point, this student had not ever understood that there is a 10 in every teen numbers. So one of the things that dyscalculics lack is that sense of numbers and numbers as groups and sets. They can count on in ones, and it's just a big pile of ones. But when you start thinking about numbers, and that there are numbers inside of other numbers, and the numbers have relationships to each other, it gets much more exciting and makes a lot more sense for them. So anyway, so here's her 11 through 20. And you can see that on the dot pattern side, she drew a line around the number 10, which is a dot pattern 5, 2 times. And then she did a 1. So you can see all the way down, she had, oh, there's a 10, and then there's another number. And same with the Cuisenaire rods, you'll see the colors. The orange line is a representation of the number 10 in Cuisenaire rod language. And so she has a 10 and a 1, a 10 and a 2, a 10 and a 3. And it was very exciting as she went down this worksheet, filling them out, coloring them in. And it was just such a new moment. And there were so many of these moments when we were going through this material of things that I thought she just understood. And a lot of things that many of us just innately understand about numbers, they don't even have to be taught in school because we just get it. But for dyscalculics, they have to be explicitly taught this. They also have to experience it. So the first thing we did was not drawing these numbers and different ways to visualize them. The first thing we did was to play with dot patterns. We had glass beads, we had rocks. We were manipulating and moving around actual physical items. Same with the Cuisenaire rods. We were using them to work with numbers in new ways, in a very visual way. I share all this just to show you a little snippet of what it was like as I was learning more about my own daughter's lack of numerical sense, and then how she started to gain that sense of numeracy. It was very exciting. And so I share this with you to encourage you in your own journey, and also to challenge the assumptions you make about what your child understands. Schools will often assume that a child has these foundational knowledge steps, and most dyscalculics don't. And that is why they struggle with their current grade level expectations, is there are foundational steps even before a grade level. Like some of these activities are not even necessarily things we learned in school, because most of us maybe innately understand them, but they are things that a dyscalculic, they need to understand and grasp and really experience these concepts before they can understand them. To learn more, check out my website, discoveringdyscalculia.com, or subscribe here.